The Lumia 650 is Microsoft's first mid-range Windows 10 smartphone, built to fit in between the 950 flagships and the budget 550 blower that launched at the tail end of 2015. We've been using the phone for a full week, and so now it's time to give you our in-depth review. One of the few criticisms leveled at the Lumia 950's hardware was the cheap-looking plasticky frame, but Microsoft has paid attention and thankfully leveled things up for the Lumia 650. This is the first affordable Microsoft mobile to feature metallic edging, which adds a touch of class and helps the phone feel reassuringly rugged. The 650 is also comfortable to clutch thanks to the rounded corners and impressively slender build. And the soft touch rear, which can be pulled off to access the battery, means the phone is less likely to slip out in your hand when things get a bit sweaty. The Lumia 650 packs a marginally bigger screen than the Lumia 550 at 5 inches compared to 4.7 inches. It's another 720p panel, making this an even match for the Moto G, and image quality is just as strong. Contrast levels are impressive while colours are pleasingly warm, with super wide viewing angles to boot. HD movies really do look good and sound alright too, thanks to a respectable front-facing speaker. And if you want to carry around a decent sized media collection, the 16 gigs of storage can be expanded via microSD. Windows 10 is of course the OS of choice, so you get all the usual array of basic Windows features, including the Cortana voice assistant and glance screen. I really like the consistent look and feel between the desktop and mobile Windows operating systems, and those loyal to the brand will appreciate the ability to move between devices with quick cloud file syncing. However, some Windows 10 features found on the flagship Lumias are very notable by their absence here. For a start, there's no Windows Hello for unlocking the handset with your eyes, but more troubling is the lack of Continuum support, most likely as a result of the Lumia 650's basic performance. This is a massive shame as the phone is being marketed to business users as well as everyday users, and Continuum is a great feature for frequent travellers. Still, it's encouraging that the Microsoft Store is much better stocked these days, with popular services such as Netflix, iPlayer, Spotify, Instagram, and Napster all supported with apps. Many of these apps aren't as nicely designed as their Android or iOS counterparts, but the majority are still at least fully featured and stable. As for connectivity, you get dual mics for clear speakerphone use, plus the same built-in antenna as the 950 designed to improve signal while also cutting battery drain. Sadly, there's no 5GHz Wi-Fi support, although at least you get 4G out of the box. A basic Snapdragon processor runs the show here, which falls behind the chips used in rival phones like the Moto G and Wiley Fox Swift. Even last year's Lumia 640 did better in benchmarking tests. Thankfully, Windows 10 runs reasonably smoothly, but you'll still notice the occasional little stutter when flicking through menus or loading up apps. Try zooming into a photo and you'll be hanging around a couple of seconds while the image refreshes. You'll also get drop frames when playing games like Minion Rush, although the latest games are at least still playable. If you want to know how good the Lumia 650's battery life is, don't forget to check out our extensive battery test video, and you can also find out about the 8MP rear snapper and the 5MP front facer in our camera review. The Lumia 650 finally introduces some premium design elements into Microsoft's mid-range offerings, and has a few positive elements that will appeal to the average consumer, including a strong screen and the £150 price point. However, the limited performance and lack of killer features such as Continuum make it difficult to recommend as a business device, especially as the competition from the Android market is very strong. For less money, you could grab a Moto G, Wiley Fox Swift, or Vodafone Prime Ultra, which offer excellent features and dependable performance. And if you're dead set on Windows, you can still pick up last year's brilliant Lumia 640 LTE for under £100. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if you have any more questions about the Microsoft Lumia 650, you can drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can read the full written review on recombo.com/mobile. Thanks for watching. Well, first impressions aren't too great, as the 950's polycarbonate plastic case is a little lackluster, especially considering the asking price.